welcome into another edition of Peacock Sports with yours truly, DJ Skylon. I'm your host, Dylon Field, and today we got a busy show for you as I sat down with Brandon Hunt, head coach of Peacock Baseball, Sami K. Shafranski, outfielder for Peacock Softball, and I sat down with Zach Carlyle to preview men's basketball's regional tournament game tomorrow as they take on the Northwest Missouri State Bearcats. So before I sat down with Coach Hunt, let's catch up on a Peacock profile as I sat down with Megan Yeager from Peacock Women's Golf.
I'm Megan Yeager. My hometown is Charles City, Iowa. I play golf here. I found Upper Iowa through a friend. I was playing at a tournament with her, and we were talking about schools we were going to, and she had mentioned Upper Iowa, and I thought I'd look into it, and it was a great fit. So I chose Upper Iowa because I like the school, I like the setting, small setting. I liked how we take two classes at a time, and then when I came and visit, I met the golf team, and I really enjoyed their company, and I thought that we'd get along great together. I started golf through my family. My dad would take me to the golf course when I was young, and we'd just go out and play a few holes, and I just started to really enjoy it, so I thought I'd do it some more. People who motivated me was probably just my family and then people at the golf course. Everybody there is family to me, and they just kept going, and I just really enjoyed the game. So when Coach gave me the call, I was ecstatic because I had really enjoyed this team. And I like the campus, so I knew it would be a great fit, and I do love it here, so. If I had to play any other sport, it may be basketball. I mean, I played it throughout high school. I might not be good at a collegiate level, but I enjoyed it in high school, so. Before I go out to the course, I usually do not eat. I mean, I get sick to my stomach, kind of. And during tournaments, I usually chomp on gum, so that's what I do every tournament. My favorite memory has to be going to regionals last year. We started slow in the fall season, but we really picked it up in the spring season, so when we saw that we made it to regionals, that had to have been one of the best moments. Most people don't know about me is I'm very, very close to my brother. We have a very good relationship. We don't fight. We get along. We talk all the time. So after graduation, I hope to get into grad school for occupational therapy.
Welcome back, Peacock fans. Pleased to be joined now by Brandon Hunt, first-year head coach of the Peacock baseball team. Coach Hunt, welcome to the show.
Thanks. Glad to be here.
Now, your first year with the Peacocks, can you kind of introduce yourself to fans who haven't met you yet?
Yeah, Brandon Hunt, originally from Rapid City, South Dakota, out in the Black Hills. Grew up out there and then attended Augustana College at the time and played baseball there for a few years. Right after college, started coaching high school ball for a few years and had some success, but knew I wanted to get back into the college game. And after the high school tenure was over, I went back to Augustana, which was now a university at that point. They've gone from college to university, and was at Augustana for the past 4 years, and then was blessed by the opportunity to get a chance to lead the Peacocks this upcoming season and hopefully into the future. So excited to be here.
What does it mean to be at the helm of this historic Peacock baseball program?
Yeah, I tell you what, I mean, as I was going through the interview process, because I had interviewed for several other jobs over the course of the years, and the thing that struck me right away, I mean, as soon as I got on campus and went through the interview process is how much passion and how much pride there is, not only for Upper Iowa just as a school, but the baseball program specifically, what Coach Danker has built here, and Coach Heller and Coach Prohaska, it's pretty cool, and it's pretty humbling to have the opportunity to be the guy that gets to call himself head coach and gets to lead and mentor and just work with 45 outstanding young men and three other coaches. That it truly is a blessing. So.
Now, you mentioned you were at Augustana for the past 4 years. Your assistant coach, Jeremy, was at Southwest Minnesota State. Can you kind of talk about how familiar you guys are with the Northern Sun? And lack for a better term, it's one of the best conferences in all of Division II.
Yeah, it's tough, and that certainly was one of the big pieces in putting together a staff, as I wanted guys that were familiar with the league. So when it comes to recruiting, which is the lifeblood of any program, they knew what type of talent that we needed to recruit in order to be able to compete in this league. So Jeremy had some playing days at St. Cloud State, and then he coached at Southwest Minnesota State, and then my GA, Tanner Neal, played 4 years, was a four-year starter at Southwest Minnesota State as well. So there was certainly some familiarity there, and every league is going to play different, just in terms of whether it's a hitting league, a pitching league, whatever it might be. Being able to have Jeremy and Tanner, who both have some familiarity with the league, and then with my background of playing and coaching at Augustana, it certainly makes it a smoother transition.
Playing and coaching at Augustana, one of the top dogs in the Northern Sun. Now, what can fans expect from your Peacock team this year and years down the road?
Yeah, no, I'm excited. We're going to play in an up-tempo style of baseball. Mm-hmm. We kind of look at it a little bit non-traditionally, just in the sense that, traditionally at the Division II level, you're not going to see a bunch of guys in the lineup that can smack doubles, triples, home runs. Most of the time, the Division I's have snagged those guys up, and for, rightly so. So I like to bunt. I like to hit and run. I love to steal bases. We like to fly around as much as we can on defense, and just, I told the guys, and I talked to them a lot, when the game starts, I want to be very hands-off as a head coach. I don't want you to be a robot and constantly be looking into the dugout or the third base coaching box and wondering what I want you to do. I want you to let your natural athleticism take over, and the hope is that we've
kind of having fun.
Yeah, the hope is that we've coached them up throughout the course of the year in practice sessions and in individual sessions, so that when the lights are on and when the game is going, they can just trust their athleticism and their instincts and truly make it the best 4 years of their lives.
Peacocks return home for the conference openers March 18th and 19th, right here in Fayette versus the University of Minnesota Duluth Bulldogs. Before we talk Peacock softball with Sami K. Shafranski, I sat down with Luis Ravello in a Peacock profile. Coach, thank you.
Hey guys, I'm Luis Ravello from Venezuela. I am a senior at Upper Iowa University, and I play baseball. I found UIU at a international program that deals with athletes from back home, and then they talked to me and I talked to them. The first option was for me to come here to the United States to learn English, and I love Fayette so much that I just decided to stay and do undergrad classes. I chose UIU because people in here are very nice, they are very welcoming, and they made me feel like I was part of the family, and then that's part of why I decided to stay here and continue my undergrad classes. I started playing baseball because I always played baseball. I played baseball since I was 3 years old, and when I came here, I always wanted to do that. And it was a funny story. I wanted to play baseball, so I came up to Coach Stanker's office and I asked him, "Hey, can I play baseball?" And he's like, "Well, I don't know who you are, but sure, let's give it a try." And then ever since then, we connected, and I was able to play my freshman, sophomore, and junior year. There are a lot of people that motivated me to play baseball. My father was one of them, my cousin. He is like a big brother to me, and he played for the Cubs minor league. And he was a very good coach. He was a really good player, and I learned everything from him and all his friends, so yeah. Oh, the first time I made the team list, or the travel list, I was very surprised. I didn't think I was going to make it, but I think he noticed that I was able to play different positions at a time, and that's what I ended up doing my freshman year. I ended up playing second base, shortstop, and third base by the end of the season, so he took advantage of trying to move me around the infield, and that was helpful for the team back then. And after sophomore year, he just put me in shortstop, and that's where I ended up doing it. I always pray before games, during games, between innings. I pray between every at bat, and that's my that's my thing. That's the only thing that I do, and that motivates me to do good. And I think God works through me, and that's how I think I'm able to help the team. My favorite memory, I think it will be when at Augustana, when I made four errors in one game, and I was able to come back and made a couple plays and help the team win that day. I think that was a it was a very difficult and frustrating moment, so I don't think I will ever forget about that. And you learn from those moments, you know. It's even though those moments are very frustrating, you learn, you grow, and you get better. It's I think that what has led me to start every game for the last couple of years has been hard work, definitely. I'm one of those persons that never give up, and like I said before, even when you have a frustrated moment, you always keep pushing, you always keep moving, and that's what has led to my success at UIU and being a shortstop for the last 2 years. It has definitely been difficult because you work with great teammates and you work with a lot of talent, so you always feel like other people are better than you, but hard work always pays off. If you keep working and if you keep working, something is gonna come out of it, you know. You either get better or you do not, and that's what I have been able to do. I try to get better every day, and it has worked so far. So yeah, well, I decided to propose to my fiance because at the baseball field, the Robertson Woods field, because baseball has always been a part of my life. Like I said before, I played since I was 3 years old, and I felt like baseball has been the only sport that taught me how to be successful, you know, taught me how to work hard, taught me how to listen to other people, has taught me how to listen to coaches and respect them and respect my teammates and how to be a teammate. So baseball has always been my life, has always been that part of me that some people don't know and that I relate baseball to every single situation in my life. So I try to connect two of my favorite parts of my life, which was my girlfriend and baseball. And I think that's what motivated me to bring her to the baseball field and propose to her on the field that I felt very comfortable on, and that's how it happened.
Welcome back, Peacock fans. Pleased to be joined now by Sami K. Shafranski from Peacock Softball. Sami, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me, Dylon.
Now, you played last year as a true freshman in the outfield on that conference tournament championship team. And then now, how are you going to use that experience this year as a leader, as a sophomore playing your second year in the outfield?
I think last year it was really good for me to kind of learn the ropes of how things worked, learn how the team kind of meshed together, learn how the outfield worked in general with the team we had, mm-hmm. with next to Sami and Katie. This year, going into conference play and our game so far, just a lot of communication, I think, is really key for us in the outfield, talking about where we're going all the time, making sure we communicate with the infield, getting the ball in quick. All that kind of stuff is some of the stuff I learned last year, and that's helped me go into this year being more prepared, I guess, for anything that can come our way. So.
Now, senior leadership, you guys have four seniors on this team, and Sami, Katie, Riley, and Tara, and they all start. Can you kind of talk about the leadership that they provide?
Yeah, I love our seniors. They are so great to have on this team. Each one of them brings a different aspect. You know, I actually came here because of Riley. Riley actually introduced me to Upper Iowa, and they're a group of girls who can motivate, who can push us to be the best that we can be, and that's something that we need. They know what to say in the situations. If if we're having a tough game, and they come in and say, okay, let's have fun, you know, let's do this, and you know, just do the best we can and give it our all. They're always good examples. They give 110% effort in everything that they do, and that's just something that I think all of us as underclassmen look up to, that we want to be someday.
Now, a different team this year. You lost a lot of key players, especially in the circle with Jacqueline and Brooke graduating. Can you kind of talk about the key players that you still have and what fans should expect come the conference opener on March 31st in Winona?
Yeah, we did lose a lot of key players last year. You know, this year I think it's going to be a different kind of way we play the game. I think last year we focused a lot on our pitchers, and we kind of would get, you know, two runs on the board, and we would be like, okay, we can play defense, and our pitchers are going to, you know, minimize any hits that they get. This year it's a little different strategy. I think we're going for, you know, we're really relying on our pitchers to have those, get those pitches in so that hitters have miss hits, and then we do the best we can in the outfield or in the infield to pick those up and do that well. I think hitting-wise, we're a really, really strong team, although we did lose some really big hitters from last year. Yeah. I think coming in, you know, we have Tara Walls in the four spot in our lineup. She's doing a great job. Sami Garrett, I know from last year, had some great games, and she's
especially clutch hits in the conference tournament.
And she's hitting the ball really, really well this year. You know, Riley's in our leadoff position, and she's a vacuum at shortstop, like anything. These past 3 weekends, at least, she's just been phenomenal. And then coming in, we have Julia Buffington, who hits the ball extremely well. Jordan Brennan, who's a freshman and a lefty, so that's something different. She's really quick, and she can hit the ball really, really well. Just all around, I think our lineup, hitting-wise, is going to be hard to stop if we can get a hold of the ball and put it out there. So,
the Peacocks will return home for the conference opener on April 1st as the Cougars of the University of Sioux Falls come to town. After that game, the Mustangs of Southwest Minnesota State University will come to town on April 2nd. Sami, thank you for joining me. And now before we sit down with Zach Carlyle to talk men's basketball, let's take a peek at the Sami Garrett Peacock profile.
My name is Sami Garrett. I'm from Ottumwa, Iowa. I'm a senior here at Upper Iowa, and I'm majoring in elementary education. I found Upper Iowa through softball. They contacted me, and I'd actually never heard of Upper Iowa before that, but I did a visit, came to a camp, and so softball was my discovery there. I chose UIU basically because the moment I stepped on campus, it felt right. I know that's kind of cheesy, but I really, really enjoyed the softball program. I liked the girls that were ahead of me just from what I'd met, you know, or who I'd met. And then I was on a tour with an assistant coach, and she just made it very relaxed and fun. And it felt right, you know, the moment I stepped on campus. So I had the same coach in basketball, softball, volleyball for travel, so in the summers and stuff, and he kind of started up each of those teams with me and a group of my friends, and he really motivated me to just stick with the sports, and he kind of created my love and passion for it. And then, you know, my mom was, you know, very supportive, wanted me to be involved, and knew that I loved, you know, playing sports, so she really motivated me along the way. It's stuff my mom will never forget. I actually was officially offered here on campus when I did a visit, and then they had me in the office, and it was nerve-wracking, that's for sure, and it wasn't expected. I didn't expect it at all to get the offer. I think my mom and I got in the car, and we looked at each other, and we were like, did that really happen? You know, is this true? So, and I knew the moment that they asked me that I was going to say yes, and I wasn't going to turn back from that. Before a game, I do a lot of people's hair. That might sound kind of funny. I braid a lot of people's hair, and one of my teammates, Sami Kay, I did her hair before a game we won in the tournament, and I told her, I said, whether you want me to or not, I'm going to braid your hair the rest of the tournament. But I really like to listen to music and get focused before a game, and then I have to have a Snickers bar. I have to eat one of those to help me out. I've done that since high school. My mom started that with me, and it's carried on. So. My favorite memory here at UIU is definitely going to the conference tournament last year and the regional tournament specifically, but as a whole, I think just the team last year, our chemistry last year was fantastic, and every moment I spent with our team last year is a favorite memory of mine, but the conference, I don't know if I'll ever have an experience that will beat that. Okay, so most people don't know about me. I can't whistle. I've never really been able to whistle, and everybody in my family can whistle, but I can't, so that's just kind of a weird thing that most people probably don't know. Oh, so last year with the conference tournament, I think we surprised a lot of people, including ourselves. You know, we started off a little slow, you know, which is kind of typical indoor season, is hard, but the moment that we started playing on dirt and, you know, just working together to get win after win, I think we, along the way, someone just said, guys, like, do you realize our record? Like, do you guys understand? Like, we never lost a doubleheader. So we you know, would either split or win both. And I think it was just, I don't remember who it was, one of the seniors. They just said, do you guys realize, like, what we're doing? And then I think from there, we were like, well, let's not overthink it now. You know, let's just keep what we're doing. But it was easy. You know, just playing with those girls last year was just easy and fun. You know, whether we were at practice inside, outside, on a game, our energy, I think, you know, we always tried to keep that up. And every position, every aspect of the game was covered. You know, our pitching was outstanding. Our catchers, you know, we're like communicating all the time, and we're supporting our pitchers, and then our infielders, outfielders, you know, just working together, and our batting lineup, you know, 1 through 9 was just, you know, if someone was down and someone else picked them up, and it was just, I think if I could just describe it, it'd just be fun. I mean, it was the most fun season, year of my life. And then when we got to the conference tournament, I think we did some more surprising of ourselves and of people. I definitely surprised myself with a lot of things, but we just took it one game at a time, enjoyed that off day that we had. You know, I've never been to the conference tournament with this team and had that off day, because you have to win both, you know, or you have to win to go on and have that off day. And we enjoyed that and just enjoyed every moment. You know, we tried to enjoy each moment we had together. And then personally, when I made the all-conference team, I, again, didn't expect anything like that. You know, looking back on the conference tournament, I definitely am proud of myself and my team, how we did. I wish I could relive it. You know, I've watched our highlight videos so many times, it's almost embarrassing, but it's definitely an honor, and I really hope I can help my team just as much this year.
Welcome back, Peacock fans. Pleased to be joined now by Zach Carlyle, Sports Information Graduate Assistant. Zach, welcome to the show.
Hey, Dylon. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Now, the Peacock men made history this year. 22 wins, a school record in the Division II era for the program. One win away from tying the school record for overall wins. Best finish ever for the program in their time in the Northern Sun Conference. Three active players in the 1,000 point club, and Hay and Carson Parker approaching that as well. Just an incredible year for the team.
Yeah, I mean, what Coach Brooks McCown has put together in his fourth year with the program, they know exactly what they're about now. And a lot of credit goes to the veterans on this team. You don't see a lot of seniors and juniors at this volume, the number, and how good they've been. That's rare to find, and you mentioned it, that the 22 wins is a Division II record. 23 wins is the all-time program record at all levels back when Upper Iowa was Division III. So
that IAC championship.
Absolutely. Back in the late 90s, they have a chance to, they're you know, here in the NCAA tournament, if they could find a way to pull off a win on Saturday, then they would tie the program record at all levels. So it's been quite the year, 16-6, as you mentioned, in the NSIC. That second seed that they earned, it's never been done before, this program. Even the good years in the Northern Sun, they finished fourth. And so being able to get to that championship game was quite the ride as well.
And then Luke Lenhart reaching 1,000 points, the third active player on this roster to reach that milestone, and the third to also do it at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls.
Yeah, this team's found a habit of those, that quarterfinal game. Jimmy Roth and Josh Weaver did it against MSU Moorhead last year in the quarterfinal game. They each reached 1,000 in that game, then Luke did it. Really struggled. He had a huge first half in that first round game.
15 points.
We thought maybe he'd get there in that game, and then didn't score in the second half, and didn't score for the majority of that St. Cloud game in the quarterfinal. But he was able to hit a huge three late. The game was already well in hand, and then Luke was able to get his 1,000. So that was quite the special day as well.
Now the road to the NSIC Sanford Health Men's Basketball Championship. A near scare in the first round of Minnesota Crookston.
Yeah, that was an interesting game. That was a very odd first round in the entire men's side of the tournament, with MSU Moorhead losing.
Agreed. No one expected that.
That was a 1-8 game, and MSU Moorhead got upset, and they dropped all the way to 6 in the region after that. And Upper Iowa had that scare too. Minnesota Crookston shot lights out, and Upper Iowa could not defend them. But the B-Docs, they battled, and they were able to have Carson Parker do his thing late in the game again. I mean, he's had three of those buzzer beaters, and so he does that, and then they get to Sioux Falls, and you just felt like once they got that first one under their belt, then they were ready to play. Yep. I mean, that first one was a scare, but once they got to Sioux Falls, they were ready to play.
Easy win over St. Cloud, convincing win, and then that huge win over Minnesota State. Third time the Peacocks beat the Mavericks this season.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the final four teams in the NSIC tournament against Minnesota State, Southwest Minnesota State, and Augustana, Upper Iowa was really good against all three of those teams this year. The three wins over Minnesota State, that was the scary part about that semifinal game. You've already beaten them twice. It's hard to beat a team three times, and they were able to do it. But you mentioned that the easy win. I didn't think it was going to be an easy win.
Yeah, Gage Davis, Scotty Stone.
St. Cloud's got a lot of talent. Mm-hmm. They can score a lot of points, and Upper Iowa just flat out locked them down defensively. Mm-hmm. 61 points they gave up in a blowout. They were in control the entire way in that one, and then they really, really had to fight with Minnesota State. That was a low-scoring kind of defensive battle, you know, kind of the pitcher's duel you have in baseball is kind of that feel to it. In basketball, and then that championship game kind of had that same type of feel. Really slow, crawling start to the game. And then the offenses picked it up. The defense, I mean, Upper Iowa's defense still played really well. They just couldn't quite score enough. But three very unique games at the Pentagon. And to go 2-1 in Sioux Falls was just quite the ride.
Especially after sweeping Southwest in the regular season, that third win is always a tough one.
Yeah, they did it against Minnesota State. They beat them all three times. That's hard to beat those two teams six times in one season. And Southwest had that revenge. I think that was on their mind a little bit in a championship game. Now, the Mustangs were a lock. They were making the NCAA tournament no matter what. But you knew they wanted to win that. And Upper Iowa did, too. The Peacock, I mean, that was on their mind because if you don't win that one, you have to wait and see if you get in, and they happen to get in, but that was quite the tense wait for them. But yeah, that was a really tough game with Southwest. There was just a lot of things that just didn't go up or Iowa's way, some uncharacteristic turnovers, some players didn't play well. Jordan Haig played extremely well. He's been playing well the entire postseason, but they just had some things not go in. They had some shots not fall, some layups not go, but I would call that one the outlier of the tournament. I mean, this Peacock team absolutely deserved to make that run all the way to the championship game.
And then now on Sunday, the Peacocks learned that they would make the NCAA Central Region tournament. They will play the host and number one seed Northwest Missouri State tomorrow.
Right. So the Division II tournament's a little bit different. Yes, it's still a 64-team bracket, but they divide it into eight regions, and so the top eight from each region make it. And Upper Iowa was fortunate to be that final number eight seed. Four of the eight are from the Northern Sun Conference. I mean, you got Southwest Minnesota State at 2, Augustana at 5, MSU Moorhead at 6, and Upper Iowa at 8. So they would each have a chance to advance to the quarterfinals if they would happen to all make it. So Upper Iowa's got the challenging task, though, against a team, the Northwest Missouri State Bearcats. The host, as you mentioned, so we have to play the road game at at Northwest, and they went 29-1. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is the MIAA champs are the only they're the only MIAA team in the NCAA tournament, but.
They had a
wins.
Couple of close games as well in the MIAA tournament.
Yeah, they really did. It was a little bit of a surprise because they'd been just beating down mm-hmm. everybody. 24 straight wins to start the year, and then they had that hiccup where they just didn't shoot well at mm-hmm. Missouri Southern State. They've won five straight, and they've been some tough ones. They mm-hmm. struggled in the semifinal game, had to hit a three almost at the buzzer mm-hmm. to win that game. Zach Schneider, the MIAA's all-time leading three-point shooter, hit the three with a couple seconds left to win that one. And they fought with Central Missouri. They ended mm-hmm. up pulling it out in the end in that championship game. But Brian's got some confidence, I think, mm-hmm. going into this one that they did not have when they played the very first
yep.
game of the season. Brian ended up losing that one by 35. And I throw that one mm-hmm. out the bag.
They're not even thinking about the score.
Yeah, I mean, that was the first game of the year back mm-hmm. in November. These two teams are very different now. Mm-hmm. So we're looking forward to that one, though. I think these Peacocks are going to come in pretty confident.
Mm-hmm. Peacocks will take on the Bearcats tomorrow. You can catch the game live at the Game Day Central portal on upperiowaathletics.com. That's all we have for you with Zach. Zach, thank you for joining me today.
Yeah, I appreciate it, Dylon.
That's all we have for you today on Peacock Sports with DJ Skylon. Don't forget to subscribe to KPCK TV on all forms of social and check us out on all forms of social media. Check out Upper Iowa Athletics at UIU Peacocks on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Upper Iowa Athletics, the official website of Peacock Athletics. Until next time, so long, take care, and cannot wait to see you out supporting your Upper Iowa University Peacocks.